everyone. It's Angela from Thread Level Quilting in APQS Raleigh. And today I want to talk to you about fonts inside of your program. So I am in PatternCAD right now, and I'm going to go over to the plugins over on the top right-hand corner of the screen, and I'm going to go to the fonts choice. This is going to bring up a font generator for QuiltPath, and it is going to use whatever fonts are in your Windows fonts directory to create new designs. So in this case, I'm going to just type in 2021, because I don't know about you guys, but I'm ready for the new year to start. And I'm going to create a font with this. So I have a couple ways that I can change my font selection. I can hit the plus and minus sign here and forward through the fonts, and it will let me choose whichever font I want. Or I can click on the name of the font and then go through my fonts list. And everybody's list is going to be slightly different because we're going to have different fonts installed on our program, on our computers, based on whichever programs we have or whichever apps we have on our system. So if you know what font you want, you can tap on it and just say okay, and it will change to that font. In this case, I'm not really sure what font I want. I want it to be kind of big and bulky, because the other thing that I want to do is show you in a future video. I'm going to take the font that we're going to use, and we are going to make a design out of it. So I think I'm going to choose this one, which is Microsoft Yay High, maybe, and save this one for what I'm going to do. So I'm going to say, I can look at, like, do I want it bold? Ooh, I kind of do like it bold. Do I want it italic? For what I'm doing, I probably don't want it italic. So I am going to choose bold so that it's a little wider for what we're going to do later, and say okay. It's going to ask me if I want to save the files. Just say yes. And then I'm just going to start a new folder for us really quick called videos, so that we can come back and get this later. And I'm going to name it 2021. Okay, so now I have a new design. QuiltPath has created a new design with this. Some things to understand about fonts. It's using the fonts that are in your Windows fonts directory, and if you were to use something like Word, you can change the outline of your font, and then there's also a fill color for your font. So in this case, it's only using the outline. It is going to be what I refer to as bubble font, right? So these the center of my zero is going to be floating. So I might be able to do some work on this and get it to be continuous, with the exception of that center, which if I want it to float, has to be a jump stitch. In this case, I'm not going to worry about that. I am going to just keep it the way it is and use it like this. I will say, if you want it to be able to join up with other things, like the first and the last letter to join up, you might want to highlight somewhere where you think your design will be able to join to, and at least move your start point. So if I highlight that one little node there, I can go to Tools and choose Move Start Point, and it does put my start point at the beginning of the edge of my number two. And then if I go to Optimize, you're going to see it just kind of jumps all over the place. I'm going to want to optimize this so that my 6 changes to a 2. I'm going to want the entire number 2, that first 2, to quilt as one number. So I'm going to go down to the area where you see the minus and the plus sign on the bottom of the screen, and I'm going to change the number to a number 2 between the minus and the plus, and then tap on the number 6. That's going to reorder that design, and QuiltPath is going to be able to take that jump stitch between the 1 and the 2 off automatically. Now I want to change the number on the 5 to a 3, so I changed the number between the minus and the plus sign to a 3, and I'm going to go up and tap on the 5. I actually want to get the 5 changed to a 3, and then the 3 on the second 2 to be changed to a 4. So that's going to make it quilt correctly from left to right across my screen. Once I get it quilting in the right order, I'm just going to say okay, and then I'll be able to resave my design. I'm not going to worry about correcting the jump stitch situation in this case, because I would have to put in a whole bunch of straight lines to get it to do that, and I would rather have it just quilt the bubble letters. And the last thing I want to do is save this design. So I'm going to go up to the little disc and hit save. And I'm just going to tap on what I've already saved and save over it. It's going to ask me if I want to overwrite my design. And I'm going to say yes. Once I have the design saved, I'm done and I'm ready for the next part of this project. We will be doing another project this weekend that will use this 2021 for the center of a border, and then we're going to save that design and teach you how to use advanced mode and set it up as a pantograph as well. So there will be three videos in this series, starting with this one and then ending with you using the designs we've been building to set up an entire pantograph. We really hope that you're having a happy and bright holiday season and that you are getting to spend at least a little time with your family and friends. I know that that's hard right now. Even if it's on Zoom, it's better than nothing, right? And please follow us on Facebook. We are APQS Raleigh. On Instagram, we are Threadwaggle. We're Threadwaggle here on YouTube. And we love seeing comments so that we don't think that I'm just talking to no one out here. So please leave me comments. I would love to hear from you and hear how your journey with Quilt Path or Quilt Church Creative Touch is going. Here's looking to a happy and healthy 2021 for all of us. And I hope you're having a great day.